Continuing on with Greek mythology and Phoenix Dreams, I'm Siddharth Sathe. We're going to talk about three more gods today. We're going to talk about Demeter, we're going to talk about Aphrodite, and we're going to talk about Hephaestus. Okay, beginning with Demeter. Demeter was the goddess of vegetation and of agriculture. So she was the protector of crops, protector of farmers. And whenever she blessed crops or fields or forests, they blossomed, they bloomed. And, you know, so nature was what she was attached with. Right? There is a very popular story about her and her daughter Persephone. Persephone was someone who set the heart of Hades racing. He was quite infatuated and attracted by her. So she's quite beautiful, being a daughter of a goddess. So Hades, the god of the underworld, kidnapped Demeter's daughter Persephone and took her down with him to the underworld. This saddened Demeter to no end, and she just gave up everything and you know, wandered around, came down to earth and wandered around earth. Now, as she was wandering around in a dejected state, everything around her withered away because she was a goddess of vegetation and of agriculture. Because of that, her state of mind reflected in the nature around her, and everything began to wither away. Now, this concerned Zeus a lot, and he knew that it would be a problem if this continued, because the entire world, the earth, would then go barren. So what Zeus did that day, since he was a brother of Hades, he spoke to his brother and convinced him to let go of Persephone. Hades agreed, but conditionally. What he said is that, yes, I will let her go, but only for 6 months in a year, which means half the year she stays with me, half the year she goes back to her mother. And that's what he did. He released her on condition. He fed her 6 pomegranate seeds, which bound her to the underworld as well, which means she was able to move away from the underworld and go back to live with her mother for 6 months. And 6 months she stayed with him in the underworld. And that is said to be the origin of seasons on the earth, because whenever Persephone goes back to the underworld with Hades, her mother goes dejected again, and that is where vegetation changes according to seasons. So seasons were formed because of this phenomenon, this event happening, where Persephone spends half the year with Hades and half the year with her mother. Right. So that's about Demeter. Moving on to the second god we're talking about today, and that is Aphrodite. Aphrodite is one of the most well-known goddesses. She was the goddess of beauty, of love, of passion and pleasures. She was said to be one of the most beautiful goddesses ever, though there were quite a few quarrels and fights about this among the goddesses, the most popular among them being the quarrel or the competition between Hera, Athena and Aphrodite. And that event, the competition of who is the fairer goddess, led to the events of the Trojan War, and we will talk about the entire Trojan War in forthcoming videos. But to give you a short insight on that, Paris, the prince of Troy, was called upon to adjudicate and judge the competition among who's the fairest goddess of them all. This was a task which actually was given to Zeus, but because he did not want to run out of favor of any of the three goddesses, one of them being his wife, he passed on the responsibility to the young prince of Troy, Paris. He adjudged Aphrodite as the fairest of all the goddesses. And what happened later led to the entire events of the Trojan War. And like I said, we'll talk about that in detail a bit later. So, yeah, Aphrodite was one of the fairest goddesses. She's also known to have a lot of relationships, affairs, so to say. She was married to Hephaestus, who we'll talk about a bit later. But also had a lot of affairs with other gods. But her most favored partner was the god of war, Ares, who we spoke about last time. But like I said, she had a lot of other relationships as well. Right, so that was Aphrodite. And the last god for today we're going to talk about is Hephaestus. Hephaestus was the son of Zeus and Hera. Now, even though he was a god, even though he was a Greek god, and the term Greek god is used with handsomeness or with good looks, Hephaestus was an exception. He was exceptionally ugly. So much so that when he was born to Hera, he was born, as the myth says, an ugly baby. And Hera, being a goddess and being the haughty goddess that she was, wasn't really very happy to see an ugly baby born to her. So out of spite, out of anger, she just threw him down from Mount Olympus. And when he fell, he was a god, so he was not mortal, so he didn't die. But the fall broke his leg, and that broken leg didn't heal at all. So wherever Hephaestus is depicted, he is depicted with a limp, with a crippled leg. So he always walks with a limp. Now, what Hephaestus is really famous about, known about, is that he is an excellent smithy. He's known as a smith of the gods. He is very, very talented in working with iron, and he was a maker of all the weapons that various Greek gods used in wars. So he's a smith of the gods. And he was also married to Aphrodite, by the way, which is done by Zeus. Again, Zeus was a very smart god. It was done by Zeus to keep Hephaestus happy, because his smithing powers were very, very essential for the gods. So to keep Hephaestus happy, he made sure that he was married to the fairest goddess of them all, Aphrodite. And since he was a talented craftsman, Hephaestus is always seen with his hammer, and is depicted by the hammer. Right. Okay, so that's it for now. We'll come back with more gods and goddesses in the next edition. Thank you very much for your time. Stay tuned with Phoenix Dreams. Keep watching us. Like, share and subscribe. And if you like what you're watching, please share. Until next time.